Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon. Would everyone please be seated? My name is Anthony Steele, and I'm proud to serve as the Assistant Superintendent Director and Principal of Blackstone Valley Tech. On behalf of our school committee, administration, and staff, I'm pleased to welcome you to join in the graduation exercises for the Valley Tech Class of 2021. It is really special. It is really special that we're gathered here on campus. In fact, it's really special that we're gathered here in person to celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2021. I am aware that many schools throughout the Commonwealth will be conducting drive-through style ceremonies again this year. I'm very grateful for the dedication of our staff and the ongoing support of the Upton Board of Health to make this event possible. Today, we will have an opportunity to honor our graduates with all the pomp and circumstance they deserve. With regard to safety and COVID, With regard to safety and COVID protocols, the Commonwealth is in a transition period of easing guidelines. For this ceremony, our students may wear masks at their discretion. Although our guest seating is spaced 6 feet apart and we are obviously outside, the guidelines recommend that the audience members remain masked. I will leave that up to you. Over my lifetime, I've noted that the most difficult experiences are almost always accompanied by incredible insight, learning, and growth. As we can see the light at the end of the tunnel with this pandemic, it is worthwhile to harvest its lessons. The pandemic has reminded us that we have so much for which to be thankful. We've become closer with our families, more in tune with looking out for each other, and we've learned to value any opportunity to the most of their senior year.
Eyes. You look at me and babe, I wanna catch on fire. It's buried in my soul, like California gold. You found the light in me that I couldn't find. So when I'm all choked up and I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. We're lovers in the night, we're poets trying to write. We don't know how to rhyme, but damn, we try.
And most importantly, my fellow members of the class. And now, I would like to acknowledge the efforts and achievements of our entire class. Our perseverance throughout all of high school, and specifically the last year, has been extraordinary. I am extremely proud of how we have navigated through the uncertainty and overwhelming nature of what turned out to be likely the most unfortunate senior year in all of history possible. It is all of these expressions of strong character and determination that make me so proud to be a member of this of our class. I know that our class is undoubtedly destined for greatness. As each of us head off to college or the workforce, whatever the next chapters of our lives may be, I want us to remember the sense of community at BVT and all that it has given us. Our closest friends, our strongest connections with teachers, our vocational educations, and a set of strong foundational life skills to guide us into adulthood. As we leave the familiar and venture into the unknown, I hope that the perseverance of our class remains strong in your hearts and is always present to guide each of us through the many testing times and hardships that will come with adulthood. I wish each and every one of us sitting here at graduation today the best of luck in our upcoming endeavors and nothing but success throughout the rest of our lives. Congratulations to the BVT class of 2021, and I can't wait to see all of the incredible things that we accomplish in our futures.
It is my honor to introduce the president of the class of 2021. He'll be attending Bridgewater State University, majoring in aviation science. From electrical in the town of Millville, please welcome Aaron Canali.
Hello, and welcome to the long-awaited BVT Class of 2021 graduation. I am glad you could all make it. I would like to begin my speech by inviting the Class of 2021 to applaud our parents, teachers, coaches, administrators, facilities, and lunch staff for all their hard work during these past 4 years. We truly couldn't have done it without you. I guess you could all give our class a round of applause for all of our hard work, too. I would like to begin with an analogy that I'll base my speech off of. I have a book here in my hand, and I believe it carries an important analogy with it. For those of you who are wondering, it is called Outliers, The Story of Success by Malcolm Gladwell. Though this book happens to be titled after the BVT of Class of 2021, I brought it along for the purpose of demonstrating how an author precisely writes a book in order to convey their message. Life is the same exact way. You must be precise in carrying out your everyday life in order to achieve your end goal. We just completed our prologues, where we were fortunate enough to attend the beautiful school, Blackstone Valley Tech. It may be hard for us to understand, but during our time here, we have been presented with an insurmountable amount of opportunity. Just like an author strategically inserting a prologue into their book, we must use our start at Blackstone Valley Tech strategically in order to get what we want out of our lives. Throughout the years, we have successfully developed bonds, attended school clubs, participated in sports, took on a trade, and learned some stuff that we may think is completely useless later on in life. All of those things, even the seemingly useless ones, will work cohesively to prepare us for taking advantage of opportunities in the real world. The next step in writing a book is developing a plot, so you may seamlessly flow into your conclusion. After reflecting on all that we have gotten out of BVT, we must now direct our attention towards what we want out of our lives and how we will use those lessons learned here to achieve those goals. At this point in our life, we are all stepping out of our prologues and into the real book. Some of us are going to a college to extend our education, others are going straight into the trade, and perhaps the most brave of us are going to serve our country and our armed forces. These are the initial steps to success. However, with success also comes failure. We are all bound to fail at some point in our life, but do not live your life in fear of failure. Embrace failure and learn from it. Remember that life is all about stepping stones. You may not just jump to your goal. You will achieve your goal after many years of hard work. We have all heard the cliche saying, a new chapter in life. This thought connects my message with my analogy. Authors use a system of chapters in order to organize and change directions. The system aids in achieving the end of the book. My two messages in addressing this point are that life may not always go as expected, and you must be organized with how you will achieve your dreams. This preparedness will be directly associated with your determination to get where you are going. I would like to conclude my speech with the idea of theme. Authors incorporate themes in order to make the purpose of writing their book clear. We are all authors of different books, but wouldn't it be nice if we all had a common theme of happiness? If we strive for happiness, we will find all other tasks in life easier, and we will be more willing to do them. Happiness does not just come and go, however. We must be willing to pursue it and be relentless to achieve it. I challenge you all to find happiness during life. If there is anybody that I know who will achieve their dreams, it is us, BVT Class of 2021. Live your life with determination, patience, confidence, integrity, compassion, and focus. It has been a true pleasure, and I look forward to seeing you all throughout life.
It is my honor to introduce the Student Council President of the Class of 2021. She'll be attending the University of Alabama, majoring in nursing. From Health Services in the town of Uxbridge, please welcome Isabella Cockerville.
It is an honor and a privilege to be standing here in front of you today delivering this speech. Now, I'm not going to get up here and say today's the first day of the rest of your life, because that's quite literally inaccurate. Or today's just the beginning, because we have all already began writing the start to our own beautiful stories. Today is the next step forward and the day that we continue to flourish. I hope we do not remember this year for the circumstances that came with it, but instead what it has taught us. Remembering the incredible parts of our lives seems difficult when everything has been turned upside down. However, this past year has taught us more than we may know. We now know how to persevere through hard times, how to stay determined and motivated on our own, how to learn in uncomfortable and unique ways, how to collaborate and use non-traditional resources, and spend what felt like an unbearable time away from our peers. Our lives were never meant to be cookie cutter, and the hard times have shaped us all into who we are. Struggles and hardships, but what you go through does not define you. Life is precious, and appreciate everything and everything that you have. We now know just how fast our favorite things can be taken away and our world can be. Although we did not get state titles, outstanding academic achievement recognitions. None of these achievements could have been made on our own if it was not for our magnificent group efforts. Work at practice, long days and nights studying, prolonged research and trials are all things that are worth being paid off. Each and every one of us has something to be proud of and to celebrate.
It is my honor to introduce the salutatorian of the Class of 2021. He'll be attending Northeastern University, majoring in computer engineering. From Engineering and Robotics in the town of Uxbridge, please welcome Casey Goyette.
Hello, parents, teachers, fellow classmates, and friends. Thank you all very much for coming today to celebrate the graduation of the Class of 2021. First of all, I'd like to give a huge shout out to all the teachers and staff for making this year work against all odds. As hard as this past year has been for all of us, they've had to deal with the same issues as everyone else on top of running a school of over 1,200 students, and I'm extremely grateful for everything they've done for us this year and throughout our entire high school career. Well, Class of 2021, we've made it. It's hard to believe that we're graduating already. It still feels like yesterday that we were freshmen walking through the front doors of BVT, a school that seemed so big and strange at first, but has become a home to us over the past 4 years. During our time here, we've all worked together, had fun together, and grown more comfortable with who we are and where we belong in this community. After today, that all changes. After today, we'll be transitioning to a new and different chapter of our lives, one in which we will have to make new friends and find our place in a new community. However, we know we're well prepared thanks to the unique program we've been a part of here at BVT, which has given us all the preparation we need for our post-secondary plans, regardless of what path we choose. When we look to what's waiting for us beyond high school, we shouldn't be intimidated by all the changes that are yet to come. We should look at it as a new and exciting opportunity for us to grow and become better. Over the past 4 years, and especially this past year, The class of 2021 has clearly shown its willingness to embrace opportunities and adapt to the many changes life throws at us. Sure, we may have passed in a few too many essays at 11:59, or completed and started some of our portfolios the week they were due, but despite the obstacles we've encountered this year, we still managed to organize fun events like senior knockout and prom and continue with our vocational and academic learning. As a class, we've weathered through it all, and based on the fact that we're all here today, I think it's safe to say we've come out on top. I'm confident that as we venture out into the world, our drive and energy as a class will allow us to succeed in whatever we do and wherever we go. I think that we'll all miss the family that BVT has become for every one of us over the past 4 years, but I know that great things are in store for the class of 2021, and I can't wait to see our legacy unfold. Thank you.
Next, would you please join me in welcoming our assistant principal for the class of 2021, Mr. Matthew Urquhart, who will give the class address.
Good evening, and welcome to the graduation celebration for the class of 2021. I am Matthew Urquhart, the assistant principal for the graduating senior class, and this is my final address to these students. But first, I would like to take a moment to acknowledge and recognize all of the people who have contributed and helped make this day possible. Especially with the year we have had, an acknowledgement of others' efforts is needed. So as a unified group, I ask that we all appreciate and recognize each other, our faculty and staff, parents and guardians, but most importantly, the students for getting through one of the most challenging times that they may ever face in their lives. Please give yourselves a well-deserved round of applause for your hard work to get to this day. As I believe we have all learned something during this last year about ourselves and others, I wanted to quickly express that I'm extremely impressed with this group of outstanding young people. If I have learned anything about them, it is that if they made it through this year-long experience of isolation, distance learning, and the disruption of life as they knew it, they can make it through anything. However challenging this time was to each of them, they proved to their parents, to their teachers, and more importantly to themselves, that they can persevere through any challenge that they may face. So I thank you, graduates, for teaching me that about you, and take solace in the fact that with all that you have endured, all that you have seen, I believe you are more than ready to face the world. It has become a tradition here for the assistant principal to address the class, to provide insight, words of wisdom, or some practical advice on how to maneuver through the challenges of life. Recognize that this advice, or in teenage speak, lectures, are offered to young people like yourselves tonight to serve the purpose of guiding you and comes from a place of caring. So here are some things that I thought you should know before you leave. You can learn a lot about someone by how much time they spend pointing out other people's failures and how little time they spend reflecting on their own. Turn your view inwards and look at yourselves first. By doing so, you will see how you should work at being a better person or being better at life. Realize the value and importance of time. As I've heard many of you these past months saying, I can't believe we're graduating, or it seems just like yesterday we were starting exploratory. Well, now you see it. Time is extremely valuable, and it passes by so quickly. So take things slowly, and don't rush everything. Stop wishing for things to come and go so fast, and just enjoy, truly enjoy, the time with your friends, family, and with yourselves. But be in the present with the people you care about, as time is something that you can't get back. Be careful not to say or do anything that you can't take back. Know that once you hit send, it is out there for everyone to view and to judge. Realize that privacy is not a bad thing and that you don't need to share everything with everyone. People don't need to know how you dress at home or how you make your favorite foods all the time, or for that matter, what your personal hygiene habits are. Some things are best left unsaid, or in many of your cases, unshared. And you don't need that many selfies. Don't take life or yourself too seriously. Be sure to laugh and be comfortable with laughing at yourself. I'll even give you a quick example, which will bring you back to my opening remarks about what I learned during this pandemic. I learned that it's a real short walk from my dining room table where I had my home office to the fridge, and that this mask is actually a protector of my chins that I've developed over this time. See how easy this is? Although I've never liked to be in disagreement with anyone, especially a fictional character like George Costanza from the sitcom Seinfeld, who believed that a lie isn't a lie if you believe it, well, my advice to you all is that if you're going to be successful in life, be true to yourselves. Start by telling yourself the truth about who you are and what you truly stand for. Look at yourselves first instead of placing blame on others. I know this may sound simple and basic, but utilize common sense and make sound judgments by genuinely taking a moment of pause, observe your situation, listen to your inner voice, and then simply make good choices. Recognize that you will face failures in your lives. Most people have a hard time defining themselves, and they define themselves by their failures because they failed. You should know that you are not your failures. You're you. Your life is a series of lessons you've learned. What you've got to do is look at your failures and go, well, now I know what not to do. Lastly, try every day to live by the golden rule. Treat others with the kindness and respect that you feel you deserve, and always be kind. Always be kind. Although there may be many uncertainties in the world, one thing is certain. You are more than prepared to take the next step. I want to congratulate all of you on reaching one of life's signature milestones. Please be proud of what you have earned here. But while your 4 years here certainly proves to be an important year in some, I'm very confident for BVT class of 2021 at least, that they won't be the best, for the best years of your life are definitely yet to come. Best of luck to all of you. It's been an honor. Go Beavers.
Thank you, Mr. Urquhart. For nearly three decades, Superintendent Director Dr. Michael Fitzpatrick has worked diligently with staff members, the school's leadership team, and the school committee representatives to shape Valley Tech into a model school system. The school system is recognized nationally as it is locally for its excellence. Under his direction and through a team effort, Valley Tech has garnered an impressive array of awards and has been highlighted in radio and television features as the new face of career technical education. He is the only superintendent in the Commonwealth to be elected by his colleagues to serve as the statewide president of the Massachusetts Association of Vocational Administrators, the Massachusetts Association of School Superintendents, and the Massachusetts Association of Regional Schools. He's a champion for quality education who has seized the opportunity to shape the vocational technical mission. One thing is for sure, with his help, Valley Tech has finally received the acclaim it has long deserved for providing high-quality career education for students from across the Blackstone Valley. Please welcome Dr. Michael Fitzpatrick.
Thank you, Mr. Steele. The thought occurred to me with one strong gust of wind, this could be the briefest speech I've ever given in 27 years. But good evening. It is an honor to be here at 65 Pleasant Street, the home of the Beavers. We join to celebrate the commencement of the class of 2021. Home is where our stories start and where our students commenced their journey. Valley Tech is a new starting point. It is often described as a home away from home. It's a welcoming space where candidates from 13 different neighboring communities come together to learn and to grow by competing with ourselves and our peers, pushing far beyond whatever goals initially thought possible with a culture of respect and support that provides and proves our school community is a lot like family. While the class of 2021 may have arrived as strangers, each person with their unique story and background, they grew and connected as the BVT chapters continued. The pursuit of vocational technical education, shaped by incredible people who see greatness within each other, even when we might not always see it in ourselves. This class has formed lasting friendships and cemented their legacy as members of our school family. This past year has clearly shown that change alters our daily lives and routines. Recent media reports has indicated that our vocabulary is constantly changing also. New words and phrases have become part of the COVID-19 vernacular. For example, 4 years ago, when the class first arrived at BVT, the word Zoom was used as a verb that defined swift action. As freshmen, they were asked to transition to the swift pace of their new school. Who would have thought that 4 years would go by so fast? Zoom. In a blink of an eye, Zoom is now commonly referred and considered to be a noun, indicating stationary learning and no movement at all. However, as this class has clearly demonstrated, adjusting and transitioning quickly to change is a skill needed to be successful in our society. Having earned the opportunity to attend BVT, our students develop a competitive spirit and a desire to succeed on their own merits. We invite them to continue to challenge themselves by setting career and educational goals and believing in themselves as they work to achieve them. Through that exciting and rewarding process, they learn to overcome obstacles and rebound from any setbacks. This leads them to do amazing things with impressive results. Success in the arena is not easily attained, but it is worth it. It is the byproduct of hard work and preparation, assisting your classmates and teammates in learning the new skills, practicing, and constantly improving together. Those things often occur when no one is watching, but contribute to a successful history and a tradition of excellence that serves our students at BVT well and beyond. In life, we have plans for the way we want things to go, but as several speakers have pointed out, life does not always work that way. As the class of 2021 will tell you, it is full of surprises. Some of them are wonderful, and some are heartbreaking. But whatever the future may hold, it is the support of the people who join us this evening, people who love us and care for us, especially during challenging times when things do not go as planned. The pandemic presented us with an unprecedented uncertainty. Our school community, a water wheel of productivity, paused as we switched gears and shifted with evolving changes in daily life. A balancing act for sure. We adopted new technology and online tools for distance learning and worked together to achieve classroom learning from the kitchen tables, from the backyard, anywhere that inspired curiosity. Hold on to that curiosity and carry it with you wherever you go through life. Continue to be a curious learner. Be confident in your knowledge, skills, and personal talents to make a difference in the world and shape a brighter future for all. Strive to reach new goals. Between ever-advancing technologies and the experiences of a pandemic, how we work, learn, and teach are evolving at an unprecedented rate. Our rising leaders need to combine their vocational tactical training with the fundamental human skills and talents that machines cannot duplicate. Critical thinking, curiosity, creativity, entrepreneurial thinking, collaboration, and complex problem solving combined with empathy and increased emotional intelligence are necessary skills to take into today's workforce. Our family of school community members, administrators, teachers, staff, coaches, and so many others that are all part of the family, along with your families, have observed your progression and growth from the very first day you arrived through this senior experience. We have seen the greatness within you tested, and we know you have the talent and the skill to succeed in your college career and life. Tonight is an exciting and joyous occasion for some 300 members of our graduating class of 2021. They will receive their vocational certificates and diploma, and we present them with pride. It is a significant milestone that marks the transition from adolescence to adulthood. We are incredibly proud of your accomplishment and welcome you as the newest members of the BVT alumni. As you move purposely to the vision that you recognize of tomorrow, you are our best ambassadors. Knowing the best way to gain unlimited opportunity, secure meaningful employment, or obtain tuition-subsidized college credentials is all through the vocational technical experience provided at Valley Tech. Please continue to foster public awareness and appreciation for your vocational technical school. You graduate prepared and ready to take the next step. Taking the next step can be a bit scary, so be sure to surround yourself, as Mr. Urquhart pointed out, with people that reflect who want you to be all that you can be and want recognize that you need the support to accomplish things. Energies are contagious as well, and experience has shown us that the best things in life are not actually things, but the people, the friendships, and the memories that we have made along the way. In a year that has been anything but ordinary, we celebrate the extraordinary class of 2021, who will make a real difference in their chosen fields. They are our pioneers. They are our innovators. They are our trailblazers. You graduate with the grit, perseverance, and skill set to tackle and achieve your future goals. Thank you for your demonstrated effort, your commitment, your dedication. You have arrived where you are today with the result of that effort and the joy of the BT family. You will always have a home here. Once a Beaver, always a Beaver. On behalf of everyone at Blackstone Valley Tech, I wish you the very best. It continues to be an honor to serve as your superintendent. Thank you.
I'd ask that you please excuse us for a while. We're going to take a few moments here to reconfigure the stage for the presentation of the diplomas. We will be back with you shortly here as we make a few adjustments, and so please bear with us. Okay, everyone, thank you for your patience. It is my pleasure to introduce you to two more key staff members here. Mr. Thomas Bellin, Vocational Director, will be calling up the shops, and Mr. Evans, our Academic Director, Coordinator, will be reading.
Having their moment on stage tonight. Thank you very much, and on to the presentation.
Will the students in the Advanced Manufacturing and Fabrication Program please rise and come? Manufacturing and Fabrication Program, please rise and come.
Brendan Ryan William Beaudreau, Milford. Darian Benjamin Collins, Milbury. Bianca Sayori Omora de Oliveira, Milford. Samuel John Shiano DiColella, Mendon. Susan Elizabeth Housekeeper, Upton. Ryan Jamil Masood, Douglas. At this time, I would like to call up Ms. Julie Mitchell, school committee member from the town of Sutton, to present the next diploma to her former kindergarten student. Cody Travis McCollum, Sutton. Robin Sage Lee Murphy, Mendon. Matthew Rudolph Scholl, Northbridge. Timothy Taft Smith, Uxbridge. Liam Patrick Strom, Mendon. Emily Catherine Valoris, Grafton. Santiago Vasquez, Mendon.
Students in the Auto Collision Repair and Refinishing Program, please rise and come forward.
Micah Michelle Allegrezza, Milford. Patrick Jason Bell, Douglas. Madeline Rose Blyle, Uxbridge. Tyler Edward Crenshaw, Millville. Peyton Rose Hartshorn, Milbury. Thank Christian Michael Lamberson, Northbridge. Jace Evan James Lindsay, Milford. Kevin Timothy Sawyer, Northbridge. Matthew John Sexton, Milford. Stephen Reginald Sweet, Milford.
Will the students in the Automotive Technology program please rise and come forward?
Kyle Richard Adams, Milbury. Joseph Austin Achu, Northbridge. Jack Anthony Ciccone, Northbridge. Jada Jane Caroline Chapman, Blackstone. Benjamin David Cortez, Douglas. Matthew Joseph DiStaro, Milford. Patrick Ryan Dunham, Upton. Matthew Nicholas Fontaine, Sutton. Trinity Milagros Gibbs, Northbridge. Thomas Robert Griffin, Northbridge. Trevor Jacob Harper, Upton. Jacob Timothy Irons, Blackstone. Emma Susan Labonte, Blackstone. Gracie Marie Lamontagne, Sutton. John Anthony Lowry, Uxbridge. Bethany Lynn McLaughlin, Millville. Jeremy Joseph Neves, Milford. Jillian Elizabeth Newcomb, Millville. Alexandria Mary West, Milford.
Will the students in the Business and Entrepreneurship Shop Please stand and come forward.
Braden John Riley Booth DeMaray, Uxbridge. Madison Lynn Deppy, Hopedale. Matthew Anthony Fiore, Grafton. Elizabeth Joy Hannon, Northbridge. Ava Marshawn Lanoue, Blackstone. Madison Taylor Magri, Blackstone. Mia Renee McCluskey, Uxbridge. Blake Hunter Stone, Sutton. Stacy Talunge Wanya, Blackstone.
Will the students in the Construction Technology program please rise and come forward.
Brian Tuttle Bizalin, Northbridge. Gavin Scott Bore, Bellingham. Cody Thomas Corey, Northbridge. Kiara Lynn Day, Bellingham. Cameron Michael Eugster, Upton. Kyle Christopher Fleming, Douglas. Brooke Olivia Hooper, Douglas. Adam Rennie Geronimo, Upton. Christopher Michael Artem Josie, Douglas. Alexis Rain Cahote, Bellingham. Jonathan Richard Lucas, Sutton. Carl Carl Asanacha Muanya, Milford. Angela Elizabeth Nolan, Grafton. Victoria Mello Pacheco, Douglas. At this time, I would like to call up Miss Erica Puda, current instructor in our business and entrepreneurship program, to present the next diploma to her son. Thomas Francis Dean Puda, Northbridge. Richard Jacob Randall, Upton. Matthew Robert Richardson, Uxbridge. Matthias Sanchez, Uxbridge. Anna Tara Thompson, Douglas.
Will the students in the cosmetology program please rise and come forward?
Haley Rose Berkowitz, Northbridge. Grace Emily Bernero, Upton. Aiden Joseph Bordeaux, Millbury. Julia Angeline Cacciola, Milford. Erin Lucretia Deal, Blackstone. Amanda Rose Ellis, Milford. Jose Renee Fontaine, Sutton. Kiara Marie Grotadaria, Sutton. Abigail Grace McKay, Northbridge. Kaylee Marie McDevitt, Blackstone. Caitlin Emily McPherson, Douglas. Thank you. Casey Burke Nigerian, Milford. Olivia Sandra Salmon, Douglas. Catherine Ann Cinco, Blackstone. Jaden Lee Snow, Sutton. Christina Marie Swenson, Blackstone. Tiggest Afton White, Sutton.
Will the students in the Culinary Arts Program please rise and come forward?
Maya Rose Ackerman, Douglas. Grace Ann Arnold, Northbridge. Katie Beth Cartarelli, Bellingham. Carrie Susan Chase, Blackstone. Alana Marie Clancy, Uxbridge. Taylor Angelica Corvasi, Sutton. Emma Pauline Cummings, Northbridge. Kirsten Jeanette Dinsmore, Upton. Kayla Joe Drew, Douglas. Tesha Lynn Houston, Milford. Jenna Rose Jennison, Sutton. Jenna Olivia Kiernan, Blackstone. Jordan Angelina Kingsbury, Northbridge. Lillian Helen McLaughlin, Northbridge. Gianna Jacinta Needham, Douglas. Elizabeth May Ponser, Mendon. Evan Anisi Porcello, Menden. Haley Lynn Purinton, Blackstone. Caitlin Leanne Rankins, Upton. Dakota Danielle Rowe, Douglas. Sadie Catherine Schmidt, Menden. Kylie Taylor Sellers, Menden. Maria Therese Treadle, Milford. Joseph Charles Tutela IV, Hopedale.
Will the students in the dental assisting program please rise and come forward?
George Harris Alexandropoulos, Blackstone. Angela Helen Fiore, Sutton. Erin Maureen Fitman, Sutton. Riley Laura Flansburg, Douglas. Elena Catherine Gobi, Milford. Audrey Megan Cariabdi, Grafton. Jack Robert Kinsella, Milford. Ava Faith LaRock, Sutton. Molly Elizabeth Magri, Blackstone. Abigail Maureen Murphy, Menden. Cassandra Haley Reardon, Blackstone. Morgan Paige Stanek, Northbridge. Isabella Bernadette Trombino, Northbridge. Caitlin Ann Zisk, Douglas.
Will the students in the Drafting and Design Technology program please rise and come forward?
Trent Alexander Allen, Millville. Jackson Alexander Alves, Milford.
Hey, Jackson! Hey, Jackson!
Gabriel George Asacker, Menden. Andrew John Benoit, Douglas. William James Callery, Bellingham. Gavin J. Shabbat, Northbridge. Thomas Matthew Cody, Bellingham. Isaac Marachnik Curley, Uxbridge.
Hey, Isaac.
Maxwell Christian Dickin, Hopedale. Alexandria Lynn Lopez, Northbridge. Connor Daniel Murphy, Milford. Nathan Saban Nackman, Northbridge. Catherine Elizabeth Randall Rosanis, Grafton. Owen Scott Silvestro, Uxbridge. Matthew John Van Fleet, Grafton.
Will the students in the electrical program please rise and come forward?
Jason John Icardi, Northbridge. Connor Patrick Barnacle, Uxbridge. Aaron Paul Canale, Millville. Angelo Joseph Cardarelli, Blackstone. Eric Francis DeCare, Sutton. Matthew Jason Desjardins, Blackstone. At this time, I would like to call up Ms. Kim Elder our vocational data specialist, to present the next diploma to her son. Brendan Benjamin Elder, Northbridge. Cameron Antonio Gallagher, Douglas. Cody James Gagne, Millbury. Joshua Stephen Harpin, Millville. Nicholas John Healy, Millbury. Anthony Michael King, Sutton. Nicholas Jeffrey McGuire, Milford. Jake Anthony Mandilli, Milford. Madison Nikolai Matthew, Douglas. Dylan Richard Rosenberg, Northbridge.
Will the students in the Electronics and Engineering Technology program please rise and come forward?
Rebecca Brooke Ashmore, Grafton. Jacob Edward Barber, Northbridge. Nicholas Aaron Beauvais, Uxbridge. Jacob Ryan Constable, Uxbridge. Kevin Julius Oliveira Downing, Northbridge. Tyler Shane Doyle, Hopedale. Samuel James Flanagan, Northbridge. Kaylee Rose Lebreck, Northbridge. John Richard Lemieux, Upton. Hannah Mary Lemanek, Sutton. Raymond Robert Mackinnon, Uxbridge. Luke Matthew Malkasian, Northbridge. Luke James Morrison, Douglas. Andrew Joseph O'Toole, Uxbridge. Joshua Michael Patnode, Douglas. Ryan Tyler Shaw, Milford. Sean Michael Tasker, Blackstone.
Will the students in the engineering and robotics program please rise and come forward?
Trin James Estrella III, Sutton. George Evan Briggs, Sutton. Ryan John Cadell, Millville. Tyler Matthew DiStefano, Sutton. Cameron Wallace Duncan, Mendon. Madison Abigail Gannon, Uxbridge. Casey Thomas Goyette, Uxbridge. Megan Mullaney Griggs, Northbridge. John William Hare, Northbridge. Donovan Smith Henkel, Milford.
Hey,
Matthew King, Sutton. Nicholas Michael Kirby, Millville. Jacob Alexander Manor, Milford.
Hey, Jacob.
Christopher Reed Nicholas Mason, Milford.
Hey, Chris.
Evan Craig Pariso, Milbury. Caroline Kevany Sanford, Uxbridge. Matthew Ross Trenholm, Northbridge. Grant Sear Van Dyke, Blackstone.
Will the students in the heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and refrigeration department please rise and come forward?
Jack Dominic Alexander, Bellingham.
Hey, Jack.
Abigail Lee Barikas, Mendon. Logan Joseph Bethel, Milford. Gabriel Chavez Silva, Hopedale. Connor Thomas Donahue, Uxbridge. Keely Bridget Farmer, Mendon. Jacob Daniel Law, Blackstone. Joshua Eric Letourneau, Millbury. Haley Elizabeth Lezak, Northbridge. Ethan Timothy Lonergan, Milford. Victoria Marie Lopez, Northbridge. Nicholas Edward Montani, Milford. Jackson Thomas Poirier, Northbridge. Matthew Michael Raposo, Uxbridge. Vivian Crescencia Staley, Hopedale. Catherine Elizabeth Serby, Mendon. Kyle Imbruno Vaughn, Northbridge. Charles Josiah Wilsey, Sutton.
Will the students in the Health Services Department please rise and come forward?
Thank you.
Emery Ann Antman, Northbridge. Melanie Isabel Bisbee, Northbridge. Jessica Stephanie Brown, Douglas. Isabella Rose Cacavelli, Uxbridge. Owen Elias Cunningham, Sutton. Molly Alyssa Curley, Uxbridge. Gianna Rosalie Dowen, Douglas. Rachel Ann Duby, Sutton. Elizabeth Ann Howell, Upton. Abby Claire Kelly, Hopedale. Cameron Louise Marie Cruz, Bellingham. Victoria Muriel Lemieux, Blackstone. Fernanda Gilarducci Lima, Milford. Marissa Renee Manganelli, Uxbridge. Caitlin Celia Manzi, Milford. Kristen Emily Wollett, Uxbridge.
Hey, Kristen.
Hannah Christine Perath, Milbury.
Yeah, Hannah.
Kushi Girish Kumar Patel, Uxbridge. Nicole Pamela Ranico, Milbury. Donna Minkov Ross, Northbridge. Lauren Amelia Testa, Menden. Haley Lynn Vecchione, Millville. Abigail Riley Weigel, Milbury. Ella Rose Yaroshevsky, Uxbridge.
Will the students in the Information Technology Department please rise and come forward?
Thank you.
Jonathan Manrique Alvarez, Northbridge. Adam Sharif Bolos, Milford. Thomas Roger Bro, Uxbridge. Kirsten Elizabeth Chapman, Upton. Nathan Matthew Dinko, Bellingham. Zachary Kenneth Ferrick, Douglas. Lisa Marie Fisk, Milford. Joshua Nicholas Greenmore, Douglas. Benjamin Joseph Hardcastle, Upton. Matthew James Hayes, Hopedale. Grant Huthantara, Northbridge. Rohit Murali Kaushik, Hopedale. Owen Henry Kies, Sutton. Jacob Richard Andrew Cruz, Bellingham. Maxwell Sean Robert Cruz, Bellingham. Devlin McConey, Uxbridge. Matthew David Martinelli, Blackstone. Ian Thomas Reed, Northbridge. Cullen Michael Ryan, Uxbridge.
Hey, Cullen.
Will the students in the Multimedia Communications Department please rise and come forward?
Anna Elizabeth Cook, Northbridge. Alethea Rose Corbett, Hopedale. Lily Ann Cordemanche, Douglas. Zachary Thomas DeRosiers, Millville. Oh. Benjamin Ryan Doyen Douglas. Mark Benjamin Driver Upton. Lauren Elizabeth Flynn Upton. Lydia Bell Gould Hopedale. Daria Corrine Hamelin, Douglas. Noah Robert Hansen, Bellingham. Krista Elizabeth Hellstrom, Douglas. Abigail Sophia Horn, Douglas. Devin Cimino James Kelly, Milford. Jack Brian Mahoney, Milford. Haley K. Fitzgerald Moore, Blackstone. Asia Danielle Parent, Douglas. Madeline Claire Poitras, Hopedale.
Will the students in the Painting and Design Technology program please rise and come forward?
Cheyenne Jalen Belargion, Uxbridge. Natalie Grace Bolduc, Bellingham. Brianna Marie Carroll, Douglas. Emily Hwali Leah Devine Sutton. Shaylani Montia Green, Northbridge. Avery Camille Gilbert, Blackstone. Donald Kenneth McCrory, Northbridge. Winter Marie Narkowitz, Milbury. Isabella Perini Pimentel, Uxbridge. Emma Irina Thayer, Uxbridge. Rosa Louise Walrath, Blackstone. Evelyn Taylor Williams, Northbridge.
Will the students in the plumbing department please rise and come forward?
Riley Lynn Bork, Blackstone. Noah Patrick Claflin, Douglas. Mario Robert D'Ascenzo Jr., Blackstone. J. Michael Finnegan, Douglas. Brianna Lucille Harper, Blackstone. Tegan Michael Jerome, Sutton. Mason Ryan Levitt, Uxbridge. Michael Christopher Maeta Jr., Northbridge. Dylan Jean Rebidou, Millbury. Ethan Riley, Milford. Sean Daniel Stewart, Grafton. Mateo Eugene Walrath, Blackstone. Lucas James Warburton, Uxbridge. Nate Warren, Sutton.
Will the class of 2021 please rise? Move your tassel from the right to the left. Folks, I now present to you the graduated class of 2021.
Thank you.